Hello everyone and welcome to Van Tech Corner. In today's video, we are going to install OpenWRT, actually it is X-WRT on the Xiaomi Mi Router R3 using TFTP. Let's use a screwdriver and a knife to open the box. And then we need to remove the antenna connectors. We will need to solder the header, and we just need TX, RX, and GND. In order to accept the router serial connection, we will need a USB to TTL adapter. It can be CP2102 or CH340 according to what you have. The TX pin should go to the RX on the router and vice versa. And the GND will go to GND for sure. Now, let's connect the USB adapter to the computer and then boot up the router. It takes quite a long time to boot up Padavan. Let's run ifconfig to get the IP of the interfaces. So right here, we can see that our LAN interface is 192.168.1.254. Let's set the IP of the computer to 192.168.1.2. Now we should be able to accept Padavan management interface at 192.168.1.254. Let's do this. Due to the difference in the MTD structure, we cannot just directly flash the OpenWRT firmware using Padavan room, but we need to do in another way. We are able to boot up the router with a serial connection, and now the second step will be downloading the firmware for the routers and then install it on the router. OpenWRT have a wide range of supported devices on the text data page. However, for the Xiaomi Mi Router 3, unfortunately there is no official support from openwrt.org. We are lucky to find XWRT support for the router. So XWRT is a Chinese fork of OpenWRT and it comes with the latest version of OpenWRT, so it should work fine in this case. And in the OpenWRT forum discussion, I found a member who shared the build for the router. So we will try it out. Let's click on the link and download our firmware. So for this kind of installation, the TFTP boot installation, we will need to find the initial RAM disk to boot the OpenWRT to the RAM of the router, and then the swash fs system upgrade to permanently write the image to NAND later. Alright, so that's it. And now let's set up our network interfaces and TFTPD server. So I will change the IP address to 192.168.1.2, which is the previous IP address that we have been using, and then start TFTPD64, select the correct interface and the folder which we have downloaded the firmware. Go to device manager and check our COM port, and then using Putty to open a command line interface with the COM port number that we found. Insert the power cable, and then once we see the text pop up on the interface, press 1 immediately. There will be some options, for example, load system code to the SD-RAM or boot from the flash memory. So we choose 1, which is boot the initial RAM disk. There will be some value we need to configure, for example, the device IP, which is the IP of the router. In this case, it will be 192.168.1.1. And input the server IP, which is our computer IP. So it will be 192.168.1.2. And now the image file name, this one will be the initial RAM disk name. We can copy the name from our folder and paste in. In order to paste using Putty, you can just right click and hit enter. So now the router should be booting up the initial RAM disk contains OpenWRT or X-WRT. It takes quite some time to boot up the OpenWRT firmware on the first boot. When we see BLAN info within mode, we know that the router has successfully boot up. And let's run ifconfig to get the LAN IP. So it is 192.168.15.1. And now we can change our IP to 192.168.15.2, or we can leave it blank because the DHCP on the router should be up and running right now. And as expected, the device received an IP address from the router. Let's open 192.168.15.1 in the browser to access the LuCI management page for XWRT. So here we are, OpenWRT or XWRT running on the Xiaomi Mi Router R3. We can see that everything is up and running, so we are going to do the final step, which is permanently flash the OpenWRT firmware to the router. Let's go to System, Backup and Flash Firmware, and select the System Upgrade file. Just proceed as you have been doing for all the devices. So now the device will restart itself and flash the OpenWRT firmware to the router permanently. It will take some minutes for sure, so you can grab a cup of coffee and enjoy. Finally, we finished flashing the OpenWRT firmware on the routers. Let me connect a cable to the one port of the router and see if it works. Perfect. 192.168.2.218 is the IP address received from the 1DHCP server. In the future, if we have the new update for X-WRT or an official support of the routers for this device, then you can always wrap the system upgrade file and then on LuCI, go to system and software upgrade and upgrade the system using this file. Let me do some other tests before we end the video. So I will try to do a speed test on the router. This will be the setup. My PC is connected to the router and the router is connected to another router on the WAN port. We are having around 90 Mbps downlink and uplink, which is not really fast since it is a fast Ethernet port. Alright, and we can see that the CPU usage is quite high when we reach 90 Mbps. Let's try the Wi-Fi. A good thing about this router is that we have both the 2.4 and the 5 GHz Wi-Fi. So let's test them out. We are having the same for the Wi-Fi, so around 90 to 80 Mbps downlink and uplink. So far, we have successfully installed OpenWRT on the Xiaomi Mi Router R3. If the video is helpful for you, please consider like, share and subscribe to the channel to support me. In the next video, I will try to set up a mesh connection between the Xiaomi Mi R3 router running X-WRT and the D-Link router running OpenWRT and the Habanero development kit if possible. And we will test out if the mesh Wi-Fi connection works perfectly between them. So see you in the next video and have a great day. Bye bye.